the use of the LMS. The rest, we can navigate, we can explore, and at least we know already some of those various activities and resources. So, daghan kaayong salamat, and I hope nga naamoy natun-an from this walkthrough with the LMS. Once again, thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hey everybody, let's do the tootie ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. Thumbs up,
thumbs up.
A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. Thumbs up,
thumbs up.
Elbows back,
elbows back.
A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. Thumbs up,
thumbs up.
Elbows back,
elbows back.
Feet apart,
feet apart.
A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. Thumbs up,
thumbs up.
Elbows back,
elbows back.
Feet apart,
feet apart.
Knees together,
knees together.
A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta.
Dale a tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, que tu cuerpo es pa' darle alegría y cosa buena. Dale a tu cuerpo alegría Macarena, hey Macarena.
Ay, Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. Ay, put the chopper on the nigga, turn him to a sprinter. Ay. Bitches on my dick, tell them give me 1 minute. Ay, Macarena, ay, ay. Ay, Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. Chopper on a nigga, turn him to a sprinter. Whoa. Bitches on my dick, tell him give me 1 minute. Ayy, Macarena. Ayy, ayy.
But I still want that. Your savage love. Your savage love, love, love. Your savage love, love, love. You could use me. Cause I still want
it like the way you know. with it, crew, drop.
My courtesy to our regional director, Dr. Evelyn Fetalvero, ARD Maria Ines C. Asuncion, and all other personnel of DepEd Davao Region. To the top management of the Department of Education, Schools Division of Davao City, headed by SDS Reynaldo M. Guillena, ASDS Basilio Manaay Jr., ASDS Emma Campo Redondo, and all the people in the division office. Cluster 2 school heads, headed by our PSDS, Dr. Isidora Sermino, teachers, parents, learners, and to the men and women of Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School, headed by our school principal, Dr. Leo B. Asilo, and the science teachers of DRANS, headed by Ma'am Maria Luz V. De Asis, good afternoon. Once again, I am Chito R. Napitan, a classroom science teacher from Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School. My task this afternoon is to share with you the guiding statements of the Philippine Department of Education entitled Embracing DepEd's Vision, Mission, and Core Values. I know that some of you may have witnessed this presentation already, last division training of trainers, and some have not heard this presentation yet. Well, I encourage you to join me today at this moment because I am very hopeful that after watching and listening in this presentation, you will internalize your roles aligned with the understanding of DepEd's vision, mission, and core values. Once you internalize your roles aligned to our organization's vision, mission, and core values, you are expected to, first, reflect on the deeper meaning of DepEd's vision, mission, and core values. And second, to convey your pledge of commitment in the realization of the DepEd's vision, mission, and in upholding of DepEd's core values. To embrace an organizational mantra, objectives, and dreams, for the non-crafters of it require effort. An effort to make the men and women of the organization understand the underpinning principles, concepts, contexts, and experiences that led to the realization of these big statements, the vision, mission, and core values of the Department of Education. This is my ultimate task this afternoon. And I hope that you will rekindle the very first day that you enter public service in the Department of Education. So sit back, relax, and join me as we embrace our vision, mission, and core values. Before we start embracing the vision, mission, and core values of DepEd, let us go back to our memory lane. What was your premise the very first day you entered the Department of Education? I will give you 20 seconds to think of an answer. You may share your answers in the comments section below. Okay, time is up. Here are some of the possible answers. Maybe you have thought to dedicate your time and energy in teaching your students. Perhaps others answered that you need to make sure that your students are learning from you. Some may consider that they will study hard so that you can teach well to your students. You may have promised that you will share a portion of your salary for the instructional materials, and some may have said that they will share their talent for the development of the school. Well, all of these promises are really good. Why do I need to ask you about this? Well, all of us made a sworn promise, this is our oath, that we will be a contributor to our department, that we will strive to do our best for our learners and stakeholders the moment we stepped in the Department of Education. More than ever, this is the time when we are most needed, not only as a teacher, but as a source of inspiration to our learners that we can learn new things, that we will embrace change, and that education can continue even with the presence of the pandemic. That together, we can adapt to change and make education happen. I hope that we will assault our routines and take humility as we are all in this learning curve. Now let's focus to our learners. I have a question once again to all of you. How do you see your incoming learners 10 to 20 years from now? Again, I will give you 20 seconds to think of an answer. You may share your answers in the comment section below once again. All right. Thank you for thinking with me. Therefore, I have prepared possible statements to answer the query. Some of you may answer like, they are successful in their chosen careers. Others thought that their learners realize their ambitions in life. Many might add that these learners will become productive citizens of the country. The majority of you might consider that these children will become responsible individuals, and a number of you may have thought that they are good parents, their children, and I know that there are more ideas with you. As teachers, we have these thoughts when we face our learners at the beginning of the school year, in the middle of it, or even during their completion and graduation. We have a strong desire to see them as such, for their success is our success too. Therefore, I would like to congratulate the teachers of Cluster 2 Secondary School for producing such people. Let us not be intimidated when our former learners are successful or richer than us. Instead, we should be grateful for they have realized their dreams when they are still dreaming inside your classroom. You too have a personal vision for yourself, in your career, in your family life, and even in your personal and financial life. Realize that vision. Think big, start small, and work every day. Therefore, what it takes for dreams to be achieved. First, clarity of dream and vision. Clarity about your dream is the single most important step to success. Successful people and organizations walk their talks. They don't give theories that don't work. They have clarity into their dreams and insight into their direction. Second, clear strategy. People or organization with clear dream and vision does not only stick to the idea, but write strategies, specific plans, and procedures to realize the dream. They are careful in thinking of these strategies. Third, aligned objectives or aligned activities. When the strategies are laid out and plans are in place, series of activities and programs shall be tested if that will work or won't work to reach that dream. Result-oriented activities are important to motivate a person or an organization like DepEd to realize a vision. And fourth, clear understanding of roles. This is very important in an organization, especially in the Department of Education. Very large organization must have a clear job and authority description to avoid overlapping of roles of people in it, and must consider that all workers in the organization are contributors to success. When people are empowered and valued, their roles are not only clear to them, but will contribute more beyond expectation. Now let us begin to look closer into our DepEd vision, mission, and core values. Let us read our DepEd vision. We dream of Filipinos who passionately love their country and whose values and competencies enable them to realize their full potential and contribute meaningfully to building the nation. As a learner-centered public institution, the Department of Education continuously improves itself to better serve its stakeholders. Let's ponder on these questions. While we are reciting, what were you thinking of? Were you visualizing for the school heads, the teachers, the learners? What or where will they be 5, 10, 20 years from now? And what will your contribution be as an instructional leader towards the realization of the DepEd vision? Now let's take a closer look. We dream of Filipinos. Our vision is more than just the end goal of a plan. It is a dream, a wish, a prayer that we fervently hope for and what we diligently work towards. By envisioning, we begin to fulfill our mandate and responsibilities stated in the Republic Act No. 9155 or Governance of Basic Education Act of 2001 and do our duties as Filipinos who passionately love their country. We want to develop learners who are true citizens and patriots who have a strong desire to serve their country and work for its betterment. So in what ways can our learners show nationalism? How can we as teachers reinforce this nationalism? To stand proud and sing the Philippine national anthem during flag ceremony is a desirable behavior every learner must learn. However, nationalism goes beyond routines. It is best demonstrated when our learners do it with passion and love, translating these routines to tangible actions like supporting local products, participating in community activities, using social media to promote Philippine pride, and many more. As teachers, we can reinforce these by modeling these behaviors to them. It sounds cliche, but our learners learn best when they see it through credible adults like us. And we whose values and competencies. We need to do two things. First, inculcate these values deemed necessary and desirable, and train students to make sure they have the necessary competencies. by looking at our K-12 framework, the ultimate goal of this program is for us to produce a whole person. A person does not only possess the knowledge and skills, but also the necessary attitudes and values. Let us not forget that as we teach the mind, we should equally educate the heart. Let's continue. Enable them to realize their full potential. What do you want to be when you grow up? That is the question that we are oftenly asking our students every start of the school year. That is why career guidance is very important to motivate our learners to choose a career, and in effect, they will become contributors to nation building. Teachers also teach them values and morals in the hope that one day, when they do find their talents and realize the greatness that they have within them, they can choose to use this for good. We need to make sure that these are happening in the classrooms, in our very own classrooms. As young as they are, our students have already their ambitions in life, and teachers need to nurture that ambition into the hearts of our students. As instructional leaders, let us help ensure that we are nurturing teachers in the classroom. Every learner in our classroom, may it be in the physical classroom or in a virtual classroom, he or she is a potential. It is our responsibility to nurture that gift, to believe in them so that they will believe in themselves. Just like the trend right now, that many are into plants. When we make an effort to plant, we must also make sure that we can provide it with basic needs and care so that it will bloom. Humans are not plants. They are a complex being. Our learners are coming from different contexts and family backgrounds, from a different socioeconomic background, as well as varied culture. Therefore, it takes energy and effort to educate them so that one day they can stand on their own, ready to meet life surprises head on. Now we continue. And contribute meaningfully to building the nation. Because as a learner-centered institution, we want them to know how to improve themselves and realize their dreams while keeping in mind the state of their country and the welfare of their people. In turn, Filipino realize their potential not for selfish gain, but to continue to build a nation every Filipino deserves. As a learner-centered public institution, the Department of Education is the government agency that formulates, implements, and coordinates policies, plans, programs, and projects in areas of formal and non-formal basic education. Always remember this. In all our decisions and actions, we put the Filipino learner first. Once again, in any decisions and actions and in any programs that we will be doing in DepEd, we always put the Filipino learner first. The Department of Education continuously improves itself. Just like our students, we do not stop learning. We constantly seek to be better, both as an institution and as individuals. That is why there are so many programs in our educational system for our learners, some of which are Bigada Eskwela, Abot Alam, Alternative Learning System, Gulayan sa Paaralan, Light Ed, Open High School Program, and all other special programs for science, arts, foreign language, and journalism. There are also Festival of Talents and sports competition so that our learners can explore their potential. But with the pandemic right now, we have to shift. There are new programs that DepEd is implementing. That is why we are really adapting to change. And these programs kept on improving. I hope one day we can go back to these kind of programs that DepEd are offering when we will go back to the face-to-face instruction. As what Charles Darwin has once said, and I quote, "It is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent. It is the one most adaptable to change." We constantly seek to be better, both as an institution and as individuals. This pandemic brought havoc to the lives and livelihood of billions of people worldwide. Education systems around the world are affected beyond imagination. However, if we only look at only one side of the coin, we fail to see the opportunities it brought. Such an opportunity is the ability of our system to be creative in developing programs to address the desire that education must happen and should continue. We will never know new islands if we will not dare sail the uncharted waters. The target is not perfection because nobody is perfect. The target is continuous improvement. Continuous improvement is a methodology that continually assesses, analyzes, and acts on the improvement of key processes, focusing on both the customer need and the desired performance that enliven DepEd's commitment to building a culture of continuous learning and improvement. It is in this line that CI's context is integrated into the learning environment to better respond to the changing times and to mobilize the vision of shaping a culture that will have a direct and relevant impact to the learners. Continuous improvement must and should be done at this time, for there are so many lessons that this pandemic has taught us. Who has thought that we can have a webinar like this with the aid of technology? These are new to us, but we have seen it that it is really doable. And as technology becomes more powerful, therefore lifelong learning on the use of these technologies to aid teaching without replacing the teacher must be our goal. Now let's continue to better serve its stakeholders. Learners, teachers, parents, local governments, and external partners. Through time, our learners have changing needs and the Department of Education must adapt and better serve these stakeholders. Excuse me. The real challenge for us all. First, conscious awareness of our vision, our mindfulness of our dream, and faith in the prayer that these will happen in the right time and the right place. Second, deep understanding and belief in the possibility. When our focus is on that goal, we should strive to transform the impossible doable. It is not positive thinking. It's making specific actions that, when combined, will lead to wonderful outcomes. Third, teachers as active agents of action and change towards this vision. As frontliners of the educational system, as marines of war against the academic freeze, and as catalysts of change, our collective actions are essential in realizing this vision. As we make the necessary decisions and actions, we place the Filipino learner first. We must not forget that we are second in rank. Given the right tools, training for knowledge and skills, nothing is impossible for a creative Filipino teacher. For a dedicated Filipino teacher will produce a holistic Filipino learner. Therefore, continuous improvement starts with us. Kudos, teachers. Now we will move to our DepEd mission. Let's read our mission. To protect and promote the right of every Filipino to quality, equitable, and culture-based and complete basic education where students learned in a child-friendly, gender-sensitive, safe, and motivating environment. Teachers facilitate learning and constantly nurture every learner. Administrators and staff, as stewards of the institution, ensure an enabling and supportive environment for effective learning to happen. And family, community, and other stakeholders are actively engaged and share responsibility for developing lifelong learners. Now let's take a closer look to our DepEd mission. To protect and promote the right of every Filipino to quality, equitable, culture-based, and complete basic education. As stated in the 1987 Philippine Constitution, our mission states our duty as stewards of education to protect and promote the right of all citizens with or without the pandemic. How do we fulfill our mission as the Department of Education in delivering quality, equitable, culture-based, and complete basic education? Well, the first mission is students learn in a child-friendly, gender-sensitive, safe, and motivating environment. Question for us to reflect. Do we provide our learners with a child-friendly, gender-sensitive, safe, and motivating environment? Our schools and the people with it must be promoting child-friendly activities, sensitive to gender roles, safe from hazards and any emotional distress. And learners are excited to come to school because there are learners who are not really happy at home, and the school is their refuge. This is sad, but it is a reality. This time is also challenging, for learning takes place at home. Another big question is, how can we help transform the home as a child-friendly, gender-sensitive, safe, and motivating environment? Having asked that, I believe that it is really important that greater partnership and constant communication must be evident more than ever between the parents, the community leaders, the guardians, and us teachers. The second mission is for us. Teachers facilitate learning and constantly nurture every learner. Question for us to reflect. Do we ensure the development of each unique learner? Having 60, 70 learners in a classroom is really tough and challenging. I always believe in the saying that you cannot give what you don't have. Therefore, when we require our learners to read, we must first read. When we require them to study, our learners must be able to see that we are prepared in going to class. When we require positive behavior from them, we must show it to them. Our actions, good or bad, reverberates to our learners. Whether we like it or not, we play a huge role in their development. Yes, we are not perfect, but we are learned beings, and since we take this calling to educate the young members of the society, it is our responsibility to nurture them. I know we cannot save all the students in our classroom, but at least we will do our best. The third mission is for our school leaders, administrators, and staff. As stewards of the institution, ensure an enabling and supportive environment for effective learning to happen. A reflection question. Do our policies, systems, processes, and behavior ensure an enabling and supportive environment for effective learning to happen? It is the mandate of the school leaders to find ways that the learning environment is conducive to learning. It is also their responsibility to see to it that more than the instructions given in the classroom, they will see to it that the physical requirements are available and enabling for learning to happen. greater responsibility is given to them in this time of the pandemic, for they have to ensure that our schools are safe from COVID-19. That is why our education leaders are working hard to see to it that that the learning continuity plan will be carefully implemented. Yes, there will be glitches along the way, for no organization is perfect. I just hope that when these policies are brought down to the system, the workforce will be given the right tools. Training is important, but teachers need tools, materials, and resources to apply what they learned from it in the hope that effective learning to happen. And we hope that safety to the teachers and all people in the Department of Education, including our learners, must be a top priority at this time of the pandemic. The final DepEd mission goes to the stakeholders. Family, community, and other stakeholders are actively engaged and share responsibility for developing lifelong learners. Let me ask you this. Do we actively practice shared governance of basic education with the entire community in developing all Filipinos? As the African proverb once states, it takes a village to raise a child. And yet, even though it seems that the support of a village is so desperately needed right now, it often seems like this concept has somewhat disappeared from our individualistic society. No man is an island. Therefore, we need all the available help to make our schools nurturing. Learning does not only happen in the classroom, but learning also takes place in different locations. That is why we must teach our children to be lifelong learners, that one day they can independently learn and apply what they learn as a contribution to nation building. And you teachers and school leaders are really part of it. Now, we are done with our mission. Now we go to DepEd, to our DepEd core values. Republic Act number 8491, or the Flag and Heraldic Act of the Philippines, states that our national motto shall be Makadios, Makatao, Makakalikasan, at Makabansa. In adopting these as our four core values, what does it mean to be Makadios, Makatao, Makakalikasan, and Makabansa in the context of the Department of Education? To begin with, let's focus on Makadios. There are two behavioral statements, and with it are the indicators. So the first behavioral statement is, expresses one's spiritual beliefs while respecting the spiritual beliefs of others. The indicators are, engages oneself in worthwhile spiritual activities, respects sacred places, respects the religious beliefs of others, demonstrates curiosity and willingness to learn about other ways to show, to other ways to express spiritual life. The second behavior statement, shows adherence to ethical principles by upholding the truth. We should encourage our learners to tell the truth, returns borrowed things in good condition, demonstrates intellectual honesty, avoid plagiarism, expects honesty from others, aspires to be fair and kind to all, identifies personal biases, recognizes and respects one's feelings and those of others. Now we move for Makatao. What are the behavior statements? First, sensitive to individual, social, and cultural differences. The indicators under this are shows respect for all, waits for one's turn, take good care of borrowed things, views mistakes as learning opportunities, upholds and respects the dignity and equality of all, including those with special needs. That is why inclusive education is very important in our system. Next, volunteers to assist others in times of need. And the last, recognizes and respects people from different economic, social, and cultural backgrounds. I would like to stress on this indicator. All work, all job may not be equal, but they are equally important in our society. May it not be equal in terms of salary, in terms of position, but as dignified people who are working hard, everyone is a contributor for nation building. Let's uplift all of us. Next, we move to demonstrates contributions towards solidarity. This is very important behavior statement in under makatao. So what are the indicators? Cooperates during activities. I hope our learners are doing it. Recognizes and accepts the contribution of others toward a goal. Third, considers diverse views. Communicates respectfully. Accepts defeats and celebrates other success. Sixth, enables others to succeed. And the last but not the least, speaks out against and prevents bullying. Now we move to the next core values. Makakalikasan. What is the behavioral statement under this? Cares for the environment and utilizes resources wisely, judiciously, and economically. What are the indicators? Shows a caring attitude toward the environment. Practice waste management. Conserves energy and resources. Takes care of school materials, facilities, and equipment. Keeps work area in order during and after work. And last but not the least, keeps one work neat and orderly. We have to instill these core values to our learners, the makakalikasan, because we only have one earth. We only have one living earth. And if our living earth will collapse, then where will we go? Mars is still under exploration. And if we go to Mars, it's very expensive. And no one can afford that. Okay? So I hope that we must consider the makakalikasan as an essential core values for all of us to learn. Now we move to makabansa. What are the behavior statements under makabansa? Demonstrates pride in being a Filipino, exercises the rights and responsibilities of a Filipino citizen. Are you proud to be a Filipino? Well, what are the indicators? First, you identify oneself as a Filipino no matter where you go. I am a Filipino, ang balat ko ay kayumanggi, and I am proud of it. You respect the flag and the Philippine national anthem. Our learners promotes the appreciation and enhancement of Filipino languages. Abides by the rules of the school, community, and country. Enables others to develop interest and pride in being a Filipino. I hope that when we go outside of the country, we will always be proud that we are from the Philippines and we love our country, the Philippines. The last behavior statements under makabansa demonstrates appropriate behavior in carrying out activities in the school, community, and country. What are the indicators that we teachers, school administrators, and learners must learn? First, manages time and personal resources efficiently and effectively. Second, perseveres to achieve goals despite difficult circumstances. And third, conducts oneself appropriately in various situations. Our national motto is arranged hierarchically, believing in God, believing in one's potential, while respecting one another, stewards of nature, and lastly, promoting nationalism for us Filipinos. Very ideal may it seem, but we can do our best to learn these values one day at a time. When we manifest and model it to our learners, for sure, they will get it from us. They will learn it from us. Because values, more than teaching it, it is best taught when we model it to the young ones. Now we move to the DepEd mandate. Join me in reading the mandate of the Department of Education. The Department of Education, DepEd, formulates, implements, and coordinates policies, plans, programs, and projects in the areas of formal and non-formal basic education. It supervises all elementary and secondary education institutions, including alternative learning systems, both public and private, and provides for the establishment and maintenance of a complete, adequate, integrated system of basic education relevant to the goals of national development. For the policy thrusts and strategic directions, what are our directions? To address the wide gaps in performance while navigating within existing constraints and in keeping with our constitutional and international commitments of providing quality basic education to all Filipinos, DepEd shall continue pursuing these policies, thrusts, and directions. Therefore, there are targeted outcomes, and these are long-term results in the hope to make an impact on every Filipino learner and in our country, Philippines. So what are the outcomes? Outcome 8.1. Every Filipino has access to complete basic education. Provide necessary basic education inputs, policy, and tool across key stages. Provide affirmative actions to learners with special needs and or learners in special circumstances. Engage the private sector in broadening opportunities for basic education. That is why partnership between private and public institutions are very important. Utilize technology in expanding the reach of basic education services. See, it's already an outcome of our Department of Education, the utilization of technology in teaching. It may be accelerated by the current pandemic, but we are really going there. As what I have said, our technology is becoming powerful. It is changing every day, and we have to keep up. Because if we will not keep up, we will lose in the competition, and we will become obsolete. Outcome 8.2. Every Filipino graduate of Philippine basic education is prepared for future education and the world of work. What are the key statements under these? Ensure that a learner-centered curriculum is implemented. Provide relevant instructional materials and equipment. Improve the quality of instruction and professional development of teachers. That is why, to the DepEd people, especially those who are holding the key positions, I have to tell this, that the teachers need tools. We need equipments. We need the resources. And I hope that these resources are available by the coming August 24, and we will be willing to work hard so that education can continue and should happen as we are given with these kind of tools before the opening of class. Outcome B, delivery of basic education services to learners is effective, efficient, and collaborative. Improve internal systems and processes. Strengthen education leadership and management, and build people's capacities. Expand the network and participation of stakeholders and strengthen. All of these things are very important in our mandate as the Department of Education in realizing our activities in our department. With our collective effort, I hope that these outcomes will be realized. As I end my presentation, I would like to leave you this quote from Brad Johnson. It states, "Relationships before rigor, grace before grades, patience before programs, love before lessons." We all know how tough this time in our educational system. The learning curve is too wide to handle. Sudden educational shift affects not only our mental and emotional state, but also our financial life, because we have to have the tools and the internet connection, no matter how costly it is, because we need to be with and in it. Webinars left and right, and the struggle to differentiate between work from home and being at home, and the information overload of the new ways of how to teach and what to teach bombard us daily. With all of these, our resilience as a teacher and as a human being shines the brightest because we are needed by our learners. The struggle is real, to be honest, but there is nothing more rewarding than to sacrifice our comfort for the future of our children, for our Filipino learners. By God's grace, we will pass these trials. Better teachers, better school officials, and better learners than ever. But never forget to take care of yourself. Self-care is love. Finally, as we embrace the DepEd vision, mission, and core values, and taking by heart and mind the DepEd mandate, we commit to serve the Filipino learners and our country, the Philippines. For the challenges are great, the expectations are high. Let us match these with our commitment to work hard, work well, and work together for the Department of Education in this new normal, because we put the Filipino learners first. Thank you for listening. Good afternoon once again.